गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी, माय नेम इज प्रदीप कुमार। आई एम वर्किंग इन नाइटिंगेल्स होम हेल्थ सर्विसेज, हैदराबाद रीजन, रिपोर्टिंग एट बेगमपेट। फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम लाइव टू प्रमोट स्टे फिट एंड स्टे एट होम। इट इज लर्न दैट वी आर अंडर lockdown since couple of days because of pandemic alert of COVID-19. So please take necessary measures and please be at home and stay at home. So friends, today I'm going to speak on tennis elbow. Now tennis elbow is a clinical condition which is very commonly seen nowadays in almost all the age group, but precisely it is very commonly seen both in males as well as in females. In females, generally between the age group of 30 to 45 years, and in males 45 to 55 years age group. Tennis elbow is also called as lateral epicondylitis. It is defined as inflammation of the lateral epicondyle. Now, lateral epicondyle, if you observe here, I'm just bending my elbow here with 90, making it a 90 degrees angle on the outside of elbow, just exactly here on the outside of elbow. This is the lateral epicondyle where it gives origin to all the extensor group of muscles. That means whatever the movements that are responsible for the wrist extension, all these muscles are arising from the lateral epicondyle, running across the forearm, and it is getting inserted into the wrist and fingers. So there are sir, these muscles are again divided into superficial group and deep group. So whenever a person does this movement, a contraction is happening here and it is directly affecting the lateral epicondyle. That means significantly the effect is shown here. So when you are performing a movement repeatedly in this fashion, obviously it tend to have an impact on the lateral epicondyle, which is on the outside of elbow. Now the question here is, there are certain causes. What are the causes generally? What are the causes of tennis elbow? The causes are nothing but if you are using your wrist movements more and more, taking into wrist extension consistently, that has a profound effect here. So it is improving it, and it is significantly focusing on the lateral epicondyle, resulting in pain, tenderness, mild swelling, and restriction range of motion, which is called as inflammation. Now the there are some exercises for this tennis elbow. So the person, whenever we are prescribing these exercises, we should check people who should do these exercises and who should not do these exercises. Now let us categorize into two categories here. Now people who should not do the exercises, those are, let us talk about them. The person who has underwent any fracture, dislocation of wrist and hand, or any comminuted fractures, or any tumor, any skin discoloration, or any lesions, or any vascular injuries, these kind of people should not do these exercises strictly. Secondly, if the pain is felt at this point when you are doing some exercises, for example, when you are doing these exercises, if the pain is aggravating more and more, very very intense, you have to stop it immediately, and you have to get back to your local physiotherapist to take a suggestion. So friends, now as I told you, this is all about the clinical condition and pathology. Now the significantly in tennis elbow, the inflammation is very very commonly seen. The features of inflammation is nothing but pain, swelling, tenderness, and restricted range of motion. So now, what is the methodology or what is the treatment generally we follow for this tennis elbow patients? Precisely, if you talk about medical management, generally we use non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs such as aspirin, ibuprofen. These will relax to some extent, but precisely and majority of the role is played by physiotherapy exercises. Now, what all the physiotherapy exercises initially you have to start with when there is a patient who is suffering from tennis elbow? So first and foremost thing is you have to check what is the intensity of the pain. So generally in a physiotherapy perspective, cryotherapy is one thing. Cryotherapy or ice therapy, which can be given in a circular fashion, which can decrease the symptoms of pain. The second thing is subcutaneous frictional massage with two fingers, that is index and middle finger. You have to, all the muscles are moving from the lateral epicondyle, running across the forearm. So we need to exactly place it on the lateral, just below the lateral epicondyle, and start giving in this forward and backward direction in this kind of maneuver, which can decrease the symptoms of pain to some immediately. Next, we have many other modalities like ultrasound therapy, which can decrease the symptoms of pain. But precisely here, exercises which can decrease the pain. So, as I told you, we are going to talk about the exercises. First is the wrist exercises. So what you have to do here is you have to just extend the wrist to the maximum extent possible, make a grip, hold it for 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Relax your fingers and take the wrist downwards. So I have done one time, this should be repeated for 5 times. Again, you have to lift it up, make a grip, count for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Relax the fingers and take it down. Take it up, make a fist, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Relax your fingers, take it down. 3 times it's been completed. Take it up, make a fist, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and take it down. Take it up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Relax it and take it down. So this is the first exercise. And the second exercise what we can do here is active free range of motion exercise. You have to place the wrist like this. Just raise your wrist like this. Hold for a count of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and take it down. Lift it up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Take it down. Lift it up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Take it down. Lift it up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And take it down. Lift it up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And take it down. Lift it up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Take it down. So this is an exercise immediately which can decrease the symptoms of pain. So I'm going to show the next possible exercises. So the next possible exercises here, what we can go ahead with is, the first one was active free range of motion exercises, which was done for wrist and hand. The second exercise is when you are extending your wrist with the opposite hand, 50% of resistance should be given in downward direction. For example, in this position my wrist is there, if I am extending my wrist, 50% of resistance should be given from the opposite side. So lift it up, you have to take the hand against the resistance, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Take it down, lift it up against the resistance of 50%, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now take it down, lift it up with 50% of resistance in downward direction, with the opposite hand. So this has a profound effect on the lateral epicondyle, and which can improve the strength of the muscle. So this to be repeated for 5 times again. The third exercise is, first one was free range of motion exercise, second one was with 50% of resistance in the opposite direction, and the third one is 100% of resistance in downward direction. The hand has to be extended, the wrist has to be extended. So I am giving in downward direction 100% of resistance, the hand is pulled back, I mean the wrist is pulled back against the resistance for a count of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and take it down. So repeat this exercise for 5 more times. So till now I have shown total of 4 exercises. One is just we have to lift the wrist up, make a grip, hold for 5 seconds and relax. This is the first exercise. The second pattern of exercise are nothing but, first one is active free range of motion exercise where there is no resistance given, you are asking the patient to extend the wrist. The second one is, the next one is, you are giving 50% of resistance in downward direction and you are asking the patient to extend the wrist. Similarly, the third one is, you are giving 100% of resistance in downward direction and asking the patient to extend the wrist. So these are some of the exercises which can be done to improve the strength of the muscles in the extensor group of muscles. So next thing is, most precisely when you look at the patient, the patient complains of pain, decreased range of motion in the elbow and weakness of the fingers. So we need to improve the grip strengthening exercises precisely, and also you have to improve the range of motion. Range of motion is nothing but, he could not able to bend his elbow totally. In order to improve the range of motion totally, you have to assess the patient and check out for MMT, manual motion testing, for flexors and extensors of elbow. So based upon our assessment, we can go for either tabletop exercises, or else we can go for against gravity exercises. So whatever the exercises I have shown you, this is the preliminary management for any kind of tennis elbow patients. Now, moving forward, if a person wants to do his activities on a daily basis, like though he has pain, though he has stiffness, he has to carry on his activities. So in such a situation, what we can do is, we can go for a band-like structure. A band-like structure can be given just below the elbow here. If this is a elbow joint, just below the elbow joint, you can give a strap or band-like structure here, which when you keep a band or strap here exactly, so whenever a person is doing movement in the wrist, that will not significantly affect the lateral epicondyle, because all the contractions will be limited to this level. That doesn't go beyond this level. So whatever the movements, generally we do this, that does not have an impact on the elbow. So we can either use a strap or we can use a tennis elbow band. So most precisely, you observe this in cricketers and sports person, like the tennis players, if you see, they wear a band. They wear a band here just below the elbow. The band is usually worn just below the elbow. So here, what the main importance of giving this band is nothing but, it will restrict the contractions to go beyond the elbow, and it will minimize the effect on the elbow, and at the same time it gives a soothing effect and decrease the symptoms of pain. So this strap like thing, or else any tennis elbow band, generally we have prescribed this For a patient from moderate to severe kind of. Next, friends, so these are some of the exercises what we need to start with and check out to improve the range of motion exercises. So totally I have showed you total of 4 exercises. And one more exercise we have. I'm going to show you one more exercise. like in the just below the elbow, just below the elbow, you have radial nerve joint, superior radial nerve joint, inferior radial nerve joint. Since we are focusing exactly on the elbow, once the elbow range of motion is completely achieved, when the patient could able to do his elbow movements to the maximum extent possible, when there is full range of motion is achieved, then we should check for radial nerve joint. The possible movements of radial nerve joints are nothing but pronation and supination, or this is also called as rotatory movements. These rotatory movements should has to be checked for. So in a normal subject, of course, you can see this in a full range, but in a patient of tennis elbow, he could not able to move in a supine position. Besides, he can do it pronation, but whenever he is doing a supine position or whenever he is taking the hand upward like this, he complains of severe pain here. So we have one more exercise for them. So currently I'm using a reflex hammer here. I'm using a reflex hammer. Either you can use a stick or you can use a very low weight of any handle like structure. So what you have to do is flex your elbow. The elbow has to be bent. The elbow has to be bent like this. Hold it. Try to take into left side. I mean onto the right side and onto the left side. Or else, for example, so this side, hold it for some time. You can see my forearm, you can see my hand, hand, it is totally bent, right? You have to precisely check whether this hand is moving totally into this moment or not. But significantly, in a patient of tennis elbow, they cannot do total movement of supination. This movement is not possible in them. So you need to teach these exercises. Ask the patient to repeat this slowly, very slowly, very slowly, passing through the center. If this is the center, considering this is the center, so you are turning onto the one side totally, bringing to the center again and turning onto the opposite totally. But in tennis elbow patients, you cannot go beyond this. You need to improve this full range of motion. So totally there are 5 exercises now. These 5 exercises will help any tennis elbow patient who are suffering with symptoms of pain from mild to moderate, moderate to severe. Friends, what all the exercises that has been shown just now, all these exercises should be done very slowly or very gently. There should not be any vigorous kind of movements. Fine. Let us talk an exceptional case where the patient has very, very severe form of pain, very, very severe form, where he could not able to at least bend his elbow, neither he could able to make finger flexion movement. So in this kind of situation, you can go for tabletop exercises. That means you take a plinth, make the patient comfortably sit, place the hand on the plinth, place the hand in mid-prone position. So this is a mid-prone position, right? So this is my mid-prone position. So this is supination and this is pronation. So place the hand in mid-prone position in this fashion and try to take it, place it on the table, try to drag it inside with the help of support of the surface and take it outside. This is for to improve the range of motion in the elbow. So this is one which can facilitate and improve the range of motion in a severe form of pain of patients. Similarly, a plinth is placed and with enough support, you can place the patient's hand in mid-prone position, take it into pronation. Similarly, take it into mid-prone position again and take it into supination. So this movement can help very, very severe form of pain. The patient is having very severe form of pain, where he could not able to tolerate the pain. If you want to initiate the movement, they are facilitated with a tabletop exercises like this under the supervision of physiotherapist. And the range of movement, the pattern of movement, and to what extent the speed of the movement will be decided by a physiotherapist. If patient is doing on his own without the supervision of physiotherapist, if there is an intense pain, please stop it immediately and get back to your physiotherapist and take an opinion from physiotherapist. Friends, Nightingale's Home Health Services is providing a free physio video consultation for all the clients. If you want to utilize it, please utilize it by reaching us at 1-800-1034530. I repeat once again, Nightingale's Home Health Services is extending a free physio video consultation for all the clients. Please avail this opportunity. Reach out for 1-800-1034530. Friends, I would request to place your comments at the. I would like to have your comments now. I can see some of the comments are coming up here. I'd like to. I would like to go through the comments. So if anybody is did not comment here, please drop a comment here. Yes. So these are some of the exercises which can help you, right? Okay. So precisely these exercises which I have shown you, yes, this will help you to improve the functional performance of the patient. So friends, please place your comments at the bottom. Please place your comments. I will address the comment once I finish the session. So one more. There is one more thing. Like we have a stretching. Let me show you the stretching. So for all the extensor group of muscles which are arising from the lateral epicondyle, there is a stretch given. So you have to extend the elbow. Place your hand on the fingers and drag it to the downward direction. Hold it for some time. Hold it. Your shoulder, elbow, wrist and heart should be straight. Pull the fingers in downward direction. Hold for some time. Count for a count of 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Relax. Please stretch here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Relax. Again, stretch here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Relax. So this is one of the stretching which can be given for extensor group of muscles, which can decrease the symptoms of pain. Right, there is one more question from Tushita. Will these exercises can be done anyone with wrist pain? No, precisely we are talking about lateral epicondyle. So that I am specifically representing the clinical condition of lateral epicondyle. Wrist is something different. If you have any wrist condition, relevant exercises will be taught for the wrist, based upon the assessment done as well as based upon the clinical condition. But I am talking about tennis elbow. So tennis elbow is something which is almost related to the wrist extension. I mean precisely I mean when the wrist movements are to such an extent where it is causing and inducing pain and inflammation in the elbow joint. So we are talking about that. But wrist exercises are completely different. We prescribe wrist exercises according to its clinical condition, which is relevant. Next, we have one more. Yafi Kurkeja. I play tennis regularly from some time. I am feeling some pain in my elbow while playing my forehead strokes. What all exercises I should do? Fine. Yeah. Yahvi.
That's a good question. Since you play quite often tennis, so what all exercises just now I shown you in this session? I have shown you 4 to 5 exercises. That is free range of motion exercises. A count of 5. With we have to count 5 and we have to repeat it for 5 times. Second one is with 50% of resistance in downward direction. Take it up. Okay, extend the wrist. Right. So third one is with 100% of resistance in downward direction, you have to extend the wrist, that is onto the affected side. If your right hand is affected, for example, that has to be on the down, the opposite hand should be placed and against the resistance should be done. So three form of exercises will help you. And at the same time, the stretch which I showed just now with, for example, shoulder extension, elbow extension and pulling the fingers in downward direction, holding for a few seconds like this, for 5 to 6 seconds and releasing. This will help you. So that is all about. So these exercises will help you. So please place your comments at the bottom. I'll go through the comments and so welcome. We hope your the clarification has been done. Thank you. So what all the comments that is going to be seen now, definitely I'll take it into consideration. I'll address all your comments once the session is completed. Friends, before I conclude, one thing I would like to tell you: a tennis elbow, though you are doing exercises, though you are doing all the stretches, it has a point of recurrence. Recurrence is nothing but once the symptoms of pain has come down, there is a tendency of recurrence. It can shoot it again. It can reoccur again. So precautions should be taken. So one thing is, as I told you, the strapping or tennis elbow band. So that will limit. It is acting as a protective this thing, and it will limit the amount of contractions that is passing from the forehand to the elbow. So if it is so severe, and if you want to avoid the recurrence, better to go for strapping, or else you can use a tennis elbow band, which will limit your symptoms. Fine. So that is all end of session. I'm looking at the time. You can show us taking you for tennis elbow. Sure. And immobilization techniques. Sure. Monisha, thanks for asking this, Monisha. But specifically, we are focusing here: stay fit and stay at home. Yes, we have different methods for doing this tennis elbow treatment. Of course, taping is one, manual therapy is one. Yes, there are different methodology. But precisely here, at the home, I mean, at once one person at a home, what possibilities are there to avoid this tennis elbow pain? What precautions can be done? What stretches can be done? What treatment can be done at home level? That is what we are focusing here. Definitely, we will take this into consideration, and I'll address you this once the session is completed. Shivani Gidala, thank you. Thanks a lot for your comment, ma'am. Wow, super informative. Thank you a lot. Yeah, it's a good question, ma'am. Cold therapy, cryotherapy, as I told you in the session only, cryotherapy is one thing which will help you to decrease the symptoms of pain. So, ice cryotherapy or ice
can be given in a subtler strokes. It can be given in subtler strokes across the lateral epicondyle, which can decrease the symptoms of pain. So precisely when you focus, cold therapy or cryotherapy has got more effect. It is highly effective than the heat therapy. Shanti Barve, thanks for your comment. Very nice information. Thanks a lot, Shruti. Thanks a lot for your comment. So what I understand here is, friends, there are different. Some of them are asking what are the various methodologies which can be used to treat tennis elbow patient. Yes, true. There are various methodologies as well. Definitely, I'll address you after the completion of the session. But precisely here, what I'm addressing is at a home. I mean, at their own home. I mean, at a staying at home. What are the possible treatments that we can avail at staying at home in this lockdown phase? To what extent we can help ourselves? So that is what I have discussed here. There is nothing but in terms of stretching, in terms of strengthening, or if in terms of some bracing or any tennis elbow band, which is helping us a lot. So this is what we covered here. Possibly regarding taping, manual therapy, and other methodologies, I'll definitely address you once the session is completed. Thank you, Monisha. Thanks a lot. I would like to thank all of you for sharing your comments here. So most of your doubts or clarification has been done. But some of them have asked for, various methodologies. Definitely, yes, taping is going to help, and I'll show you the practical how the tape is placed. And the second thing is manual therapy. Yes, there are some manual therapy techniques generally we use. So definitely, I'll show you that. So Kranti Kumar Kotapuri has come up with a question here. Hi doctor, does physiotherapy help in this condition? So as I told you, Mr. Kranti, 80% of treatment, 10 to 20% of treatment will be helped with non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs such as aspirin and ibuprofen. But majority of tennis elbow patients will be cured with physical therapy stretches, strengthening exercises, as well as I told you, the cryotherapy. Yes, it has got an evidence-based practice. We generally follow evidence-based practice. That implies that yes, the study has been done taking into sample. So we have studies has been done on sample, taking into sample. Like for example, for 25 patients, we have done a comparative study based upon that evidence-based practice. We have concluded that yes, these strengthening exercises, stretches, and a tennis elbow band will be helping a patient to the maximum extent possible. That is almost 80 to 90% without recurrence. So, if you want, I can share you the articles as well, which has been done recently. Thanks a lot, Kranti. Thanks a lot for your your doubt. That has been clarified. So I'm waiting for other comments. So friends, I think almost all your doubts have been clarified. I'll definitely address you once the session is completed. So I feel there are some questions here regarding the other methodology. I'll show you once the session is completed. So I think all the comments no more comments are been coming up, and all your clarification has been done. So thanks a lot. Thanks a lot for joining this session, and I'll definitely come up with a few more methodologies. So I would like to thank all the participants here. At the same time, sharing your comments here. Thank you. Thank you very much.